What's going on guys, SP Architects here. In today's video we are going to model this vehicle bridge, and this is not going to be ordinary modeling style just comparing to another stuff like buildings or classical modeling tools. We are going to use the morph tool, and you will learn much more about modeling with morph tool. But before we get started the tutorial, I would just like to ask you to like this tutorial. It's going to help this channel to growing up, and I suggest you to subscribe because I'm going to make similar tutorials 3 times in a week. So let's get right into that. Here I am in ARCHICAD and I have imported several images as reference, and we are going to rescale these reference images to the real scales in ARCHICAD. As you can see here, we have some dimensions and it's 180 meters from this grid and to this C0. So I'm going to click this and hit Ctrl plus key for resize. Click this one, hold shift the key and click this C3. And then import input 180, but this is millimeters, 18 centimeters and meters. Let's just check it out. Go to options, project preferences, working units, and click the centimeter right here and click OK. Now let's measure it again. So it's true. 180 centimeters. After that, I'm going to rescale other reference images. For instance, we have this one. As you can see here, we have 160 centimeters. Hit Ctrl plus key and make this value to 160. There we go. This is okay, and the next time we are going to rescale this one, rotate, and I'm going to align these corners first, but instead of here I can use this one because I don't have any useful dimensions right here, so I'm going to use this reference image. But in this situation we need some reference lines like that, and I'm going to align this image to the reference lines from this corner and to the this corner, and this will be our full length of the bridge. Let's measure it, and it's 180. Actually, it's true. And also we have this one, this columns or base for the bridge. In this case, we can use this pedestrian way. I'm going to align this corner and this reference line. Again, hit Ctrl plus K. From here and to here. There we go. And this was the last part. For this part of the bridge, as you can see here, we have a triangle, and this triangle corners looking to up and this part is looking to down. So we are going to turn this triangle and again turn this triangle upwards. And it's the same here. So let's model some morph. I'm going to reference from here. And I'm going to mirror this. Hold the shift and select both. Right click, Boolean and Union. But by the way, I'm going to cut out this elevation from here and go to south elevation and paste. And place somewhere here. I have placed the reference image over here and go to floor plan again. And I'm going to center this triangle to our elevation. And move to the center. Now go to 3D and rotate, Ctrl plus E, hold click and choose the axis, and then second click the this direction and change the direction to upwards, and go to floor plan again, rotate to 90 degrees, go to south elevation, and I'm going to move this reference image, align them, and rise our triangle to here. Then I'm going to pick up this spline tool over here. And underline this reference image. First, I'm going to try the clicking these peak points, and after finishing that, I will try to changing this by clicking this changing method over here. By clicking this, we will see this changing lines next to our points, and we can directly change our spline modeling here. And also this one. Here are reference editing parts. Now I'm going to pick up the morph tool again and hit the spacebar. Click our spline. Not this one. Spline, please. Okay. Now we have a 3D line and we can see that in the 3D view. I'm going to use 3D spline for reference. After that, I'm going to click our triangle and click this point over here. And here we have cube options. Click this one. Actually, before that we have to delete this inner edge, so hit Ctrl Shift and click that one and just delete and make cube again, and I'm going to move something 50 cm. After that you will see that these pencil options will appear, and I'm going to choose this arc tangential to previous segments. Yeah. And I'm going to click our reference line one by one. Maybe this seems a bit weird, so I hit Ctrl plus Z again. Click this point. This time I'm going to come here 5 cm. And I'm going to try the second one. First, click the destination and decide the curve. And continue like that. I think it's going to be better. I have modeled this part, and in the 3D window, I'm going to select with Ctrl plus Shift these edges and click the corner. And here we have this box stretch. With this box stretch, we are going to scale it down and stretch from center. Maybe something like this. And to finish that, just click outside over here. And we are going to do the same each part for the bridge. But instead of doing this, I'm going to prefer hit Ctrl plus Z And the easiest way of doing this, going to South Elevation over here and click the corners points actually, and make that on the reference image like so, and you will see that this is going to be much faster and easier. As you can see here, I have copied this reference morph to here and changed its orientation and anchor points according to reference image, and I'm trying to refer that helper morph to gain our shape. For instance, I just click this corner and align, click here and align. There we go. Let's go to 3D view to look what we have. As you can see here, we have to fix this side part. In this X direction, it looks cool, but when we look from this Y direction, it looks some kind of weird. We can fix this, or we don't have to. I just leave it to you, but I'm going to fix that and complete the shape. But again, to doing this one, we can refer a plan from over here, but I cannot see any useful parts, so maybe we can just make a simple line and mirror, and we can refer this line from the floor plan and fix our morph. Control Shift K and just scale. By doing that in the floor plan, it's just stretching it out in the only Y direction, not Z direction. As you can see here, it's still the same with the Z direction, but this floor plan directions are changing when we are using resizing stretching. I have completed the half of the shape. After that, I'm going to split it from the center and delete one part and mirror a copy, shift select the second and union, and it will be easier. Yeah, and now it's time to underline this floor plan over here, and we can copy it to there. And now we only have to model this vehicle path, and then we will be ready to go. Let's copy this one, go to options, profile manager, click the new and paste here, just center that and use the line tool, underline. We have a bulb here, but I will make it straight. Also here, after finishing one part, I'm going to copy it, mirror, and fill the inside with fill tool. There we go. And again, I'm going to stitch this with three additional parts and select this one. Select this all right surfaces, and I'm going to choose pavement asphalt light, and this will be pavement asphalt dark. Yeah, and use with beam and wall. Click save. Go to floor plan. Go to wall. Click the new profile. And make a straight line to the bridge. But we cannot see that. Go to floor plan, or we can go to section over here. Or maybe we can fix that on the profile manager. Just Ctrl plus A to select them all. And click this most outer corner and align to the center. Or instead of that, we can align this corner to the center. It will nearly the same. After doing that, I want to see all of the profile in the floor plan. To do that, hit Ctrl plus T and click this all revealed in story, outlines only, and click OK. There we go. And right click this one. But I need another corner here to make a curved or bowl shape over here. So I'm going to add another node here to the center and then right click and convert selection to morph. And now I'm just going to click this outer pedestrian roads and fix it manually. Of course, it's too set. I cannot select the edge with this selection. I can only select the visible corners, not under this corner. So I have to fix that points one by one. Like so. And of course, after doing the first one, we can mirror it. Yeah, it looks quite cool. But we have to fix that in the elevation. Just select our road. And maybe we can align the center points and rise up the elevation for the bridge. And of course we can do the same. Make a spline and convert it to the morph to see that in the 3D view. So we can make our, or actually we can reference this spline in the 3D. Yeah, okay, there we go. And now I'm going to pick up the morph tool and hit the space, click the spline and go to floor plan. It will be selectable over here, or actually here, and align the center parts like so and go to F3. And now I'm just going to hit Ctrl plus Shift and move this corner to here. I'm going to make the same. We just select the roads, our roads, and hit the shift, select our reference morph with F5 to isolate them. Again, hit Ctrl plus Shift to select inner edges. Click the upmost corner and align. But as you can see here, we have a space here, and actually it's not true. We have it leave as is. In this case, we are going to click this corner and extrude, but in this case we cannot see the extrusion push pull options here. Sometimes ArchiCAD does this problem. Therefore, I'm going to click the closest face and train to, as you can see, it will be appeared. And now I'm going to use tube tool now. And now we can get rid of this part from the floor plan. Just it or click this split, make a line, click this left part, delete, and here again we can close the shape like so, and also this part. There we go. This part we are going to model this base for the bridge. To achieve that, I'm going to make a section center of the bridge. And I'm going to copy this image, go to our new section, open the curve into your settings, and paste. As you can see here, we have two triangles, and also we have two triangles. We are going to align this shape to our current model. But I'm trying to make drawing first. After that, I'm going to rescale that according to our model. I just sketch over there and simplify it. After that, I'm going to use morph tool to fill the inside and extrude it to gain some volume. Or instead of doing that, I have copied it in the floor plan and used the slab tool to make it extruded. And I can directly input volume from here and convert selection to morph. Okay. And rotate to the Z axis. Like that. There we go. Pretty easy. And move to the location where we use. Then I'm going to push this inside to under the bridge construction. I click the face and drag the face a little to the right to give that more thickness. And then I'm going to give that some slope over its faces, both from right and left side. I simply select the face and hit Ctrl plus E to rotate, and rotate it from upwards to the downwards. Also this side. I input the same value for both faces. For the bottom base, I'm going to use slab tool instead of push-pull the morph tool, because speed is important and we will gain some time when we are using like this. After that, I'm going to change this slab to the morph if I will need to. I didn't like the thickness of this base, so I click the box stretching and stretch it to the both sides. When I satisfy the shape, I just click anywhere except the shape. For the safety railing, we are going to use railing tool. When using that railing tool, we are going to click the edges one by one. Since this was a morph tool, not slab, we cannot use automatic railing on that. There we go. But this model, all of these railings, got my computer slowed down. Because in the railing, actually in the standard railing, it uses pipe posts, and that post has too many polygon vertices. So when I use railing with big projects like that, I prefer using only box post or handrails and other parts. There we go. Now my computer works faster. Now it's time to mirror that railings from the axis of the bridge. But since the model is not symmetric, our railing went to the wrong location. Therefore, we move it to the location manually. But as you can see here, we have modeling issues. It's not symmetrical. So we have to make it symmetrical. I just did the model as four parts. After that, I'm gonna take symmetry all of the parts. There we go. Now our bridge is symmetrical and ready for additional details. I'm going to make some landscape. To doing that, I'm going to mesh tool. I just click the basic rectangular and make a basic rectangle shape like this one. And I'm gonna add additional points to here and here. And in the 3D menu, I'm going to give that some thickness over there. I'm gonna click the bottom points of the mesh if I just click and click the mesh, click this extrude and to the ground, actually to the base of the bridge. And I'm gonna give this some slope. To do that, I just click the points from the green parts. When I got satisfied from the slope, I'm gonna get this closer to the bridge. And I want to give this part different material. I simply slice the surface and click the second part and change the material from options menu from this override surfaces. I'm gonna use earth and click OK. There we go. After doing that, I'm gonna make the bottom part of the river. I'm just going to use the basic mesh tool again. But before doing this one, I go to floor plan and mirror the earth and fulfill the shape from the floor plan with this basic polygonal construction method. After that, I go to 3D view and place that to the right place. There we go. Now it's time to add some water. To do that, again, I'm just going to use mesh tool again and use the polygonal construction method for that. And I'm gonna give that thickness to the ground, to the bottom of the river. And just change the material to the water and also override surfaces. Alright, now I'm just going to trim unnecessary parts of the river water. I use the solid element operations. I'm just going to select earth for the operators and river for the target. I'm going to select subtract from downwards and hit execute. There we go. We have pretty nice water and our bridge onto that. Yeah. Now I want to extend the roads to the forest. Actually, I want to add some forest on the rendering. I just make a simple road as we did before and convert it to the morph, you know. And once we did it, I'm going to stretch it by making some 3D selection if I can. And then I'm just going to drag the points to align our straight wall. Actually, this is a road after this moment to our bridge. I'm just going to do the same for this part of the road. After doing the left side of the road, I'm just going to copy to the right side and align the corners to the bridge. Actually, it's a bit more easier in the floor plan, so I get some help from the floor plan selection. Alright, now we are at the final part. We are going to make the steel ropes for the construction of the bridge. But actually, this model for now looks straight for me. To make that aesthetic, I'm going to give some slope to do this construction elements, construction hangers, I think. In the building selection, I'm gonna give this some slope. Maybe it's going to be 5 degrees. After that, I'm gonna get rid of this part and mirror it from the center of the from the bridge. There we go. Now for the construction ropes, I'm gonna make an axis and I'm going to add our construction ropes with column tool, but I'm gonna insert the columns on this reference line. Just click the column tool and click over here on the line. After doing that, I'm going to fix that height in the 3D view and arrange its slope in the 3D view according to our construction hanger. There we go. After doing that, in the elevation, I'm going to hit the Ctrl plus U for multiply it and I'm just going to array the construction ropes along the bridge, actually to center, to the center. After completing that, I'm going to fix the height of the columns one by one, because if I use the subtraction from upwards or downwards from the bridge, I cannot use the complex construction method for the columns. You will see that why I'm trying to use the long way for that. I'm going to make mark selection and fix the rest from the 3D view and get symmetry from the center and axis. As for the final step, I just select all of the columns and give that composite structure and change their properties, slopes and thickness. And at the final, it's going to be looked like this. Not completely true, but still quite useful. If I had enough time, I had been modeled this with correct way, but this was a quite long tutorial, and that does the trick. So I just get rid of that doing that. Alright guys, that was pretty much it for this tutorial, and this was a very long tutorial, I know that. Therefore, I did cut to the chase, as you can realize. Please like and subscribe. And if you want to download this model, you can find it in my Patreon page. I'll be waiting you in the next part.